Today we're going to upgrade the memory of an HP Pavilion model TP01-1016. We'll open up the case and replace the 1 8-GB module that originally came with the computer with a pair of 16-GB sticks of RAM for a total of 32GB. We'll also confirm the memory size in the BIOS and in Windows. Before we open up the computer, I'm going to enter the BIOS and see what we can configure for the memory. As the HP logo appears, I'll immediately hit the Escape key, which displays this blue menu. In the top left corner, it already gives us a clue as to what's installed. There's 8GB of DDR4 memory running at 2666 MHz in single-channel mode. As you can see, there's only one memory module installed in a two-slot system. Let's hit the F10 key to enter the BIOS. I'm afraid there's not much more that the BIOS can tell us. Though it shows us there's 8GB of memory, it doesn't expose the timing information, nor the ability to tweak anything, at least on the main screen. If I navigate to the other tabs, there's no further information about the memory. Unfortunately, it looks like whatever memory we install, we won't be able to configure anything about it. When we enter Windows and look at the Task Manager, we can confirm we have 8GB installed as one module out of two slots, running at 2666 MHz. Let's close out of Task Manager and shut down the machine so we can install the memory. I'll be using a pair of Team Group's T-Force Vulcan Z DDR4 modules, each being 16GB in size for a total of 32GB. Notice that these are rated at 3200 MHz, which I fully expect not to be able to reach due to the limitations of the BIOS. I suspect it'll drop the speeds down to 2666 MHz. For memory rated at CL16, the timings aren't that great, but that's okay. They were cheap, and I'm not using this computer as a gaming machine. During the installation, I'll be using an ESD strap to prevent any static damage, and a screwdriver with a T15 Torx bit. If you don't have a Torx bit, you can use a flathead screwdriver instead. In a previous video, I showed you how to disassemble the case to show you the upgradeability of all the components inside this HP Pavilion model. In this video, I'll focus only on the steps necessary to install the memory. If you'd like, you can visit the other video from the link I've placed in the upper right-hand corner, as well as in the description. The first thing you'll want to do is take your Torx or flathead screwdriver to remove one screw in the back of the unit. The screw stays attached to the panel, so you can leave it in place. You can then slide off the side panel. As we pan up to a higher angle, you'll see the existing memory, which is partially obstructed by a black cage and a silver tray. To make it easier to install the memory, I'll remove the cage by unfastening this screw. Next, I'll angle the cage and lift up to remove it. The next step is removing the silver tray. To prepare, I'll remove the SATA power and data cables from the DVD drive and press the green lever to release the drive through the front. Next, let's turn the case around and remove the front face by lifting up on these three tabs. Grab the bottom of the face and pull it away. You'll then need to remove this screw, which allows you to lift the silver tray. Bend this flexible metal bracket to free the spare SATA power connector and lift up on the tray to remove. Let's switch to an overhead view, where I'll slide on my ESD strap and clip the other end to the metal part of the case. You can see an M2 NVMe SSD module that I installed in a previously published video, to which I restored a factory image of Windows after the installation. Feel free to visit if you're interested. I'll place a link as a card in the upper right-hand corner. However, for this video, we'll be focusing on the memory, which is right here. As you can see, there's an existing stick in the top slot. To remove it, you'll want to press down on the white tabs on either side of the memory until it pops out. This happens to be a Samsung 8GB module rated at 2666 MHz. Let's grab one of our new sticks of 16GB memory and take note of the notch on the module to the notch on one of the memory slots. You'll want to align them together, make sure it's in the slot, and then press down on either side of the module until you hear an oddly satisfying click. Afterwards, you can verify the tabs are indeed in their upright positions. Let's take the other module and do the same thing. Before I do that, let me open up the tabs first. Let's align the notches, make sure it's in the slot, press down on either side until you hear those clicks again, and verify the tabs are locked in place. Reassembling the case is now just a matter of reversing the steps. remount the silver tray, fasten the screw, replace the front cover with another oddly satisfying click, insert the DVD drive until you hear, you guessed it, spin the case around, where we'll angle in the cage, fasten the screw, reconnect the SATA power and data to the DVD writer, and secure the spare SATA connector in the silver tray's bracket. Finally, slide the side panel back on and screw it back together. With that, let's turn on the computer and launch the BIOS again. On the initial screen, we see the 32 gigabytes of RAM detected. But it's worse than we thought. They're running at 2400 MHz, which is oddly unsatisfying. That means we won't be able to achieve the potential of the extra 800 MHz, so keep that in mind when you purchase your RAM. Again, the BIOS doesn't tell us much other than the fact that it detects 32 GB. And in Windows, we can indeed see 32 GB populated in two slots running at 2400 MHz. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.